Hello, this is the RPG Chick, and welcome to Let's Play Tacoma. Finally out, well, you're seeing it 2 days after I'm recording it, but, yeah, they said it was going to be out August 2nd, and August 1st it becomes available, well, the evening of or something. Pretty cool. Well, technically I'm playing it in the early morning hours of the 2nd. This is a science fiction... not sure, like a narrative story exploration type game of a space vessel put out by the Fullbright Company, the same people who made the Gone Home game. Just going through settings, you guys, reticle is fine, not ridicule, interact text, like not completely sure. I guess text that pops up when you interact with something. Yeah, actually know what that is. It tells you to grab stuff, or that might be the tutorial. I'm not sure. AR desktop timeline markers. I'm not sure what that means. Augmented reality. Head bob. I'm keeping on. I mean, these things are subject to... I might just turn these off at some point. Being as I'm not really sure how they're implemented in the game, what they look like, I'm going to keep them on for now. That's the default. Controls, I really didn't... I rebound my keys to what I wanted, and that's about it. Language, subtitles. I don't know what this is, in-world overlay. In-world overlay. So non-native language only. I'm not sure what that is. Non-native language, I guess, if spoken in the game, the language I don't recognize, it will display them as captions in the in-world overlay. I'm not even sure. It says all enabled and as disabled. So it was set to this. I'm going to keep it to this. Find out what the hell that's about. Sound turned down a little bit so you guys can hear me. Graphics, I have everything up to high. I'm not sure. It's weird because, well, it's just low and high. But display, I guess, is if you have multiple monitors. Like texture quality has low, max, and then high. Wouldn't max be higher than high? I'm thinking max means like the highest possible. So why is it max and then high? I'm applying. Applying, okay. It didn't do that before when I changed it. I think it was set to high. Shadows are just on. Shadow resolution. We got medium, low, very high. Is that what I had it set to? Which is good. Alright. And that's it. It's really, I played very little. I played basically like 5 minutes in and then stopped. I'm like, okay, I got a hang of the controls and such, and I can talk over voices and still be slightly heard over, so it's good. So, otherwise, guys, this game is completely blind. I have not played it past, like, 5 minutes. I have not gone even into the tutorial, so. Bling! Very excited for this game. It already reminds me of, like, Event Zero. If anyone's who played I played that back in earlier in the year. Very fun game.
All right, Minnie. Ready to start docking sequence?
Okay. Engaging retro thrusters now.
Oh boy. Minnie ship.
Lunar transfer station Tacoma. Commercial cargo transit facility.
Everything looking good to me.
Crew evacuated. Station AI offline.
Air supply?
Breathable air on Tacoma for a crew of one should be more than sufficient. Docking now.
Contacting target facility, Lunar Transfer Station, Tacoma. Handshake complete. Contractor vessel cleared for docking. Guidance software. Handshaking. Turning us around. Gonna back it on in. Alright. Magnetic tow tethers attached. Contractor vessel. Gantry now in progress. We're docking.
Docked.
Nice. That. Thanks, Minnie.
That. Now that's neat. Amy, Tacoma job. So just to warn you guys, I read all the things, so stuff that can be read will be read. Oh, those are my boobs. Do I have pointy boobs? I swear I wasn't going for the Madonna look. I like the electrical tape there. Very professional. So anyway, yeah. Very excited about this game. I know it's probably going to be a short one. A short-ish one. Nelson's. So, I don't know what that says. It says things in two different... Well, it says things in a bunch of different languages that I do not speak. So it's not translating this in the in-game overlay or in-world overlay. Caution, AI hardware enclosure, do not tamper. What? Obsidian class. HW install. Hardware install. Verified. Okay, 22988. Sim run. 10,000 of 10,000. Okay, verified by H. Why do we have plywood? Here's the electrical tape we've been seeing. That goes there with the rest of the tape. Guessing that's water? What does that say? Fire suppression? It's all very jury-rigged together, isn't it? So we can't really mess with any controls. It's all turned off, I guess, once I took that thing. Oh, I got a spork. Probably used with those ramen noodles or whatever the hell it was. That's one heavy spork. There's something... Oh, it's a toggle crouch. Okay, we got crouch. No jump. We've got these controls for pausing and fast-forwarding and rewinding something. I don't know. Install AI wetware here. Well, I guess we don't have that. If there's an inventory, there's no key to access it.
Minnie, I'm headed in. Talk to you when I'm back. Don't let anybody scan the ship while I'm gone.
Okay.
Danger. Airlock door in motion. Fans. Now this is where I played up to. Well, I activated this thing. See, we can't even go anywhere. So I'm guessing this is part of the tutorial. Now these things, I thought they were like earbuds, but they go next to your ear. Hardware transmits critical audiovisual information directly into your sensory cortex. Please affix your Venturis hardware to interface with this facility. Ooh, look at that. Ooh, fancy. Left hardware node attached, and right. Venturis Technologies Eros Initializing Augmented Reality Operating System. Hello, user.
Hello, I am Odin, Lunar Transfer Station Tacoma's Operational Data Interface Network.
You're freaky.
I have recorded this message to welcome you, guests, aboard. Before I can set up your station profile, you must register your body positional data with Tacoma's AR tracking systems. Please place your hand on the AR figure's palm.
Sounds like James Earl Jones. Oh, I could open that. So yeah, this thing. Illuminati confirmed. I can play the message again. Let's see, open this. Cool. Yeah, let me sell that space. Space! You can open this one too. There's no like sprint or walk faster button. Cool. All the space. We can open those though. Alright, listen carefully for instructions from Odin. AR tracking required. Please register your body positional data with Tacoma's AR tracking system. By entering this Venturis facility, sure I'll zoom in, I can read it though, you consent to the following. This facility uses augmented reality body positional tracking for a multitude of critical functions. Visitor body positional data as well as audio and visual data may be retained by Venturis Technologies and its subsidiaries to better ensure the highest level of security and service. Sounds fishy to me. By entering this facility, you relinquish all rights to any data collected from the augmented reality system and release Venturis from any future liability for its retention or use in perpetuity. In other words, we can monitor all your crap and we take responsibility for nothing. That's what that basically means. This feels funky. Oh, so funky. Oh, weird. We're twinsies.
Your body positional data has been registered with Tacoma's AR network.
That was freaky at the end.
Please sign in to confirm your identity.
I don't have an identity. My name is Amy something. Amy Ferrier.
Thank you. Welcome aboard.
Can I read that or is it going to go... It went away.
While aboard Tacoma Station, please remember that all activity on this facility is monitored by AR recording. Mm-hmm. All activity records become sole property of the Venturis Corporation. Any questions about privacy or personal
I read it. Okay, it got screwed up there. Tacoma Station Data Network warning, massive data loss detected. Recoverable AR data found. Entering data recovery mode. This thing went flying past me. What's this? Sanitation drone? Neat. Cleaning unit. Do not service vacuum unit while it is in operation. High suction hot metal surfaces. Wear protective eyewear and observe caution at all times. Romeo. Automated air filtering drone, serial number, blah, 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 blah. Is that what USB ports look like these days? It's like USB 169.0. I release you, drone. Have fun. In 0G. Wrapper. Disposable heat blanket. Up to 6 hours of heat. Sweet! It's got... Those all look like thumbprints. They look all... Whoever had this had all thumbs. Do not open the outer package until ready to use. Remove blanket from the protective package and expose the blanket to air. Allow 15 to 20 minutes to allow the blanket to heat. Not long. After use, discard blanket. Do not use if the perforation in the plastic has been opened previously. The internal foil lined bag has been opened, which... the internal? That looks okay. Or the package appears to have been punctured, torn, or tampered with in any way. The contents may be compromised. I guess it was tampered in any way. Because, well, it was opened. Contents. Iron powder. Water, activated carbon, vermiculite, wood powder, and salt. Huh. I'm just down, right? I'm not crouching. What do we do here? Access denied. User mission something. Can't stop floating. User mission parameters do not currently require access to this section of the facility. Well, I'm not going to listen to you. You lost your data, so you can't stop me now. Is that the same drone? Are you cleaning? At least something's working around here. Cryogenics. Well, that's the overlay they were talking about. Okay, cool. We might need that in the future, so I'm gonna keep that on. Access denied. Same. This way to the Tacoma Dome. I'm upside down or something. Can I just go like this now? Wait. Bring your friends, or don't. Am I facing the right way? Okay. Cryogenics. Engineering. Hello, my friend. You seem to be operating optimally. Let's go to biomedical, then. Blue team, 32. 27 orange team. Oh! You're playing basketball. Oh, so the hoop's after. Like nothing on Earth, use tab to toggle your air desktop. Rather magnificent, Odin says. Alright, tab. Oh! Is this me? Oh, so my nickname is Amy. I'm really Amit Giotti Ferrier. Corporate security, pre-LV8, data systems IV plus certified. Class C micrograv okay. AI communications specialist, citizenship, California American. Issued Fountain of Paradise. Fontaine de Paradis. Proof of technical certification. California Republic. What? You got California as a separate... Oh, I have other things I can choose. So California is a separate nation? From Venturis Technologies. Subcontractor Ferrier. Sign on to Tacoma's AR network successful. Please proceed to the personnel module to begin the AR transfer process. Your progress will be tracked. Venturis Contractor Liaison 68179. Well, this is a 2 of 2. It's 1 of 2. Subcontractor Ferrier, we have transmitted Tacoma docking codes to your mini. Right, that's the thing that was talking to us in the beginning of the game. Please proceed to the facility without delay. Well, I'm delaying now because I'm looking at all this crap. Okay. I guess this is where I am on the map or something. Yeah. Can I click on... No, I just exit. Okay. Venturis Technologies. Contract bid accepted. Confidentiality terms accepted. Facility access clearance transmitted. Subcontractor mission brief. Because we have to find out what the hell we're really here. Crew of Lunar Transfer Station Tacoma evacuated. Subcontractor shall board Tacoma, proceed to data access points in each habitable section, and transfer AI data from station to subcontractor vessel. Retrieve AI central processing wetwork. Return intact AI to Venturis. Subcontractor agrees to provide data transfer hardware and transport vessel. Subcontractor verifies transport vessel is capable of supporting Obsidian class artificial intelligence. A Venturis representative will be in contact remotely. So I need to go to data access points in each habitable section. So at some point I'm going to need to get into cryogenics. Some way. And transfer AI data from station to my vessel, and then get the AI central processing where it work, and then get back to my vessel, and then blah blah blah. Okay. Crew roster. Function. Cargo transfer point between Earth's surface and Zenith Lunar Resort. Cargo delivery managed by automated drone. Crew responsibilities. Oversee safe transit of cargo as it passes through facility. So we got Station Administrator Evie St. James, Operations Specialist Clive Siddiqui. Oh, we can expand this, okay. Oh, okay. Network specialist Natalie Kurashenko. She's cute. Mechanical engineer Roberta Williams. Hey, is that a Sierra reference? Roberta Williams. Medic Sarah Hazmati. I'm not sure how to pronounce the first word. Andrew Dagyab, botanist. Okay. Alright, that's that. So that was that, and then we got this. That's me. And then there's this, the map. Messages. That's me, and that's close. Okay. Onward. Personnel. Personnel access. Initiate. Act. Oh. Should I be going here first or the next one? Oh. I guess I'll go to personnel. Ventura's Belt. Orbital Vacation Bungalows. The perfect family getaway. Coming 2088. Pre-registration open now. How pleasant. Oh. Now entering personnel module. Cool. Request gravity tow. Shaft is currently unoccupied. So I have a message. From Venturis Technologies, of course. The company has remotely disabled the station's AI, the station AI's ability to directly affect operations on Tacoma or contact you via the station's AR net. Any attempt to communicate with the AI is strictly prohibited. Really? Huh? They don't want us finding out what happened here, evidently. Or just to retrieve the AI so they can, I guess, recycle it for their own purposes? Just a guess there. Seems kind of shifty to me. So I guess if we had gravity, we could climb all that way on a ladder. Sounds fun. We do have gravity now. Is this the botanist work here? Attention, subcractor ferry. All data access here. Attach data transfer device. That's my little notebook thing. Inbound message. Okay, we can send you secure messages through this interface, but it's a one-way connection. We'll be monitoring the situation from here. It's going to take a while for the first part of the AI net to go up. This is no simple file transfer. Well, I didn't do anything yet. I didn't get any AI. Upload to docked vessel personnel. Biomed. Okay. Well, I guess I'm just gonna leave this here for now. And let it do its thing. Let's go to administration. Obsolescence Day party this way. Huh. Are they being decommissioned or something? Is that a crack in the floor? Administration. Hello, administration. Conference room. Botanist stuff. Well, let's go out here first. Oh. Recoverable AR crew record data found. Captured 3 days ago. Press space. It's not space, isn't it? It's that. I like the signs, like sign language. Death sentence? What?
I can't believe it. No, you told me we get renewed. Yeah, but I meant us, not the whole crew. I guess there's just something special. Something special about Tacoma Crew 88. Yeah, not just special, it's unprecedented.
Oh, it's Roberta Williams.
It's never happened before.
So, Natalie.
Everything happens once.
Natalie.
No, personally, I'm happy for us.
Happy to be stuck up here with these people for another year.
Some of them. Some of them aren't as pissy as you. What's so bad about these people?
Well, they live in a tin can for one thing.
I think it's locked. A pretty nice can.
Oh, and you have a pretty nice can.
Oh, yeah? Well, I think you have a pretty nice can.
What?
Can you just try and make a go of it? One more year. Then we'll be back home in Singapore. You wouldn't believe the offshore habs they're building these days. 360-degree ocean views. Personal drone dock on the mainland. It's called paradise.
One more year.
One more year.
Odin's masterpiece.
Sarah, come on up.
Andrew, Dagab, and...
Gather round, everyone. As per Obsolescence Day tradition, tonight's festivities have been planned entirely by our all-knowing, all-seeing computer companion, Odin.
He's freaking.
Specifications for the cake, the decor. We humans only did the grunt work in his grand plan. And so for your enjoyment tonight...
Oh!
Whoa.
Odin, what was that?
Debris has... I have righted the station's orbit.
Meteor shower?
It's getting all funky.
But they said...
Wait, so there's no oxygen on the station except what we're breathing right now?
Correct. Additionally...
How long did it all? Sarah?
Jesus, how much
we should have
has?
About 48 hours of breathable air.
Trying other AR channels.
If Odin's readings are correct.
All right, I'll have VT send up a fresh supply straight away.
Guys, it might not be that easy.
Oh.
Additionally, external communications have been lost.
Jesus.
So we've got no air supply, no external comms, no way to call for help. Well, anybody got any bright ideas?